The internet is getting smaller. I mean, it's not shrinking. There are nearly 2 billion sites and growing, but the screens on which we access the web are. With almost 55% of users accessing the internet solely on their smartphones, e-commerce transactions are increasingly taking places on smaller devices.
So what does your online store look like on a smaller screen? Is it easy to go from browsing to checking out? It's important to consider e-commerce on smartphones, so let's take a look at how to best optimize your online store.
So, here are a few things to ensure those smartphone visitors are getting the best experience on your e-commerce site. Starting off with focus on the user experience. If your user has a poor experience on your website, then you won't be shown to those who are searching Google for your product and services, period. Creating a good website or online shop is all about making sure it's easy to use throughout the purchasing journey, even on a small screen. So make sure you have taken the e-commerce journey yourself on a smartphone so you know what your customers experience.
When building any kind of website, you have to think about it through the lens of mobile first, which can be difficult because you'll most likely be building it on a laptop or desktop computer. But of course, you want your website to look great on laptop or desktop, but don't forget mobile. And as you build your site, test it on your phone. Have your friends test it too. And then write down any issues, roadblocks, or dead ends you run into as you navigate the site on mobile. And consider using website building tool that is specifically mobile optimized right from the start. And there are many mobile optimized layouts and designs you can choose that are made to look good actually on both large and small screens and maintain that optimization as you customize.
And a good mobile site has a clear and simple navigation. Add your primary call to actions to your navigation bar to make sure that they are easy to access, even by someone with a large thumb or long fingernails on their tiny touchscreen, or like my fiance, super long nails. A huge bonus here because you can present your site visitors with several options above the fold without making them scroll down the page. You'll also want to organize your products into categories to make it easy for customers to click and browse. If you have more than 20 products, consider adding a search bar so your customers can find your products in just a few clicks.
Next, you need to optimize product listings. Make sure all images link somewhere and all links and buttons work. Seems like simple advice, but it's overlooked all the time. So go click around, make sure it's all doing what it's supposed to, and be sure all listings show a product image, price, and buy button above the scroll line at the top of the page. And you want to make sure the most important information is visible without having to scroll down the page.
And since you want people to actually buy your products, then you should probably make it easy for them to do that. If 45% of people are buying from their phones, then you have to make sure it's easy to conduct e-commerce on even the smallest smartphone. One way to make sure people are completing a purchase is to reduce the number of steps required during the checkout process. More steps means more opportunities to abandon the process and buy somewhere else that is easy and familiar, like Amazon. Collect necessary information like first and last name, email address, and phone number, and avoid anything that's unnecessary. You can always follow up after the purchase is made with an email asking for other information you may want to collect.
Optimizing a website or e-commerce store for smartphones isn't expensive. Shocking, I know. I feel like everything costs so much these days, but it isn't expensive. In fact, it's all about streamlining and minimalizing. More and more of us are becoming solely dependent on their smartphones for access to the internet. So if they can't figure out how to navigate your e-commerce platform, they will just find somewhere else to buy, which you don't want to happen. All right, that's a wrap, but your journey doesn't have to end here. We have over 250 videos for you to watch.
So be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching. This is The Journey.